Tänään alkaa MTVn uusi poliisisarja Kylmää terästä. Sen päähenkilö on komissaario Wes Kennedy, jonka vaimo joutuu järjettömän murhan uhriksi ja näin Kennedy jää kahden teini-ikäisen lapsensa yksinhuoltajaksi. Sarjassa esiintyy värikäs yhdistelmä toimintaa ja ihmissuhteita. Sarja esitetään nyt kesäkaudella joka torstai tähän samaan aikaan ja se jatkuu vielä syyskaudella.
Suomen myydyin on tuonut Toyota-liikkeisiin taas näyttävästi vaihtoautoja. Mukana ovat parhaat vuosikerrat, erinomaiset erikoisuudet, malleja moneen makuun. Tervetuloa valitsemaan suosituslistalla. Koeajan voit voittaa matkan RAC-ralliin. Hyvää matkaa!
Heippa te nuoret. Tervetuloa Lukukanavalle. Sinä minässä on...
Fiilistä!
Runoa, rockia ja rakkautta. Sinä minä, lehtipisteestä.
Target Parketti on tehty kestämään talosi ikä. Sen kauneus säilyy pitkään. Pitkään.
Aito. Target.
Baby, baby. Hey, kiddo, you sound like you're in a good mood.
Yeah, up already?
Well, a while ago.
Yeah, only need 6 hours sleep, huh? Gotta stop kidding yourself, Dad. You're an old man.
Wise guy. How's your sister? She all right?
Sure.
She get there?
Uh-huh, hand delivered to Mary by me, personally. Dad, they're only having dinner.
Dinner? They're picking out at some taco stand.
You worry too much. I mean, of course you have to worry. Women don't seem to know what's good for them. You know, I think the biologists got it all wrong. I think they're from a different species.
What's bothering you?
Man, you always know, don't you? That's spooky.
Come on, what is it?
Well, today in English, old man Holt murdered me.
Holt?
Yeah, fifth period English, right there in front of everyone, he goes, "This kid is a scholar." I thought I was gonna die. I thought teachers were educated. Doesn't he know what he did to me?
Was he serious?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. What are people gonna think?
People or that other species?
Oh, yeah, girls especially. I mean, having a brain is such a total turnoff to girls. All they want is muscle.
Muscles you can earn. But intelligence, either you got it or you don't.
And you got a lot, kiddo. Be proud of it and be grateful.
Yeah, try and explain that to the girls in my English class. Women.
Down the fire escape.
Okay.
Who are you?
Kennedy, DHD.
Hold it right there, police officers! Hold it! I said freeze!
Hands away from your bodies. Now turn around slowly.
On the car.
What the devil are you doing here?
Nothing.
That's a great answer. You. What's your name?
Cadiz, sir.
I want you to take the female down to DHD. Deliver it to the watch commander there and no one else, understand? His name is Van Duzer. Tell him I want her held until I get there.
I got it. Come on, kid.
You're gonna have to go with this officer. Not you.
Let him go. He didn't do anything.
You heard the man.
Hey, man, it wasn't my idea. It was the chick's, all right?
What was?
She's seen them cops coming, says, I go to get out of here.
Why? What did you see up there? What made you run?
She's the one what split, man.
Is she your girl?
Don't believe this. My girl! Look at me, man, and take a look at her.
Why, what's wrong with her?
Look at her! How uncool can you get?
Then, what were you doing with her?
Nothing. I just, you know, when I seen a split, like, I figure it's gotta be for a reason, you know? So I took off, too.
Put them on the list. Make sure we can find them if we need to. Hey, got a couple of guys down the mouth of the alley. They're coming down the fire escape.
Who are you?
Kennedy, DHD.
Great, your victim's upstairs.
What is this place?
Oh, this junk hole is known as the Cypher Club. You know, for the zero generation. Hips, lips, and fingertips. I gotta tell you something, brother. That's a feature of mankind in there. I think I'll just quit the human race.
Sawyer, Smith, go run up some rats at the end of the alley.
RDA Ground Zero, every move is starring you. And the world will turn to flowing pink papers too.
Culture shock, Kennedy. See what I mean?
Can't you control this?
I can't do a thing till I get more manpower down here, pal.
Forget it. I need this place shut down, and I want all the names and addresses and make them prove it before you let anybody go.
Thank you. There goes the rest of my life.
Don't suppose anybody heard the shot, huh?
Huh?
Forget it. Well, where's the body? Nobody saw anything, nobody heard anything, huh?
We got nothing because nobody cares, Kennedy.
know this guy?
No.
You ever seen him before? Then what are you looking at?
Death is in, Jack. Where you been?
Get lost.
Johnny, go get your gun. For the commies are in our hemisphere today.
I seen him, man. I seen the whole thing.
Stanley, listen to me. The victim was a friend of his, understand? And he saw the whole thing.
You can't get anything out of him. He's a space cadet.
He just shot him, man.
Who did?
This guy. He started arguing, and my buddy walks away, okay? And this guy pulls a gun. He just shoots him in the back. Just like that.
Stanley, give me a good face. And with this eyewitness, we got the killer. Take Danny over there and work up a composite, will you?
All right, I'll try.
You know, there was nothing I could do about it. Yeah. You know,
come on, kid, come on.
Stanley.
Huh?
Where is she?
Hey, what's been going on?
Where is she?
In the cop room.
Never could have happened if it wasn't for you. God, I will never forgive you. Never.
Well, well, Detective Kennedy, how nice of you to visit us poor souls down here at DHD.
Ed, come on now. Do you know where I've been?
Do I now? What am I, a mind reader?
Well, I forgot to call it in, okay?
Oh, well, so what? Could happen to anybody, right? Why should the watch commander care what his men are doing?
I'm sorry.
What are you carrying now? About 29 unsolved cases, aren't you?
Yeah, as long as everyone else here.
Yeah, well, what are you doing out there looking for some more?
Sir, it'll all be in the report as soon as I type it up.
And that's another thing. Cut out the $10 words this time. This ain't Harvard, you know. It's a police department. Get in here. And shut the door.
So how you doing, kid? You okay?
So far.
So what the hell is she doing here? Did I get it right? She left a crime scene.
Yeah.
You're not gonna push for it, are you?
I don't know.
Well, did she do anything wrong? I mean, did she witness the crime? What the hell was your daughter doing down there anyway?
It's a pretty good question, isn't it? Can we talk about this now?
What, my sentence?
You could get one. Technically, you violated the law. You left the scene of a crime.
So go ahead, bust me.
Was your brother in on this?
No. And don't try pumping him because he doesn't know anything.
I don't work that way, and you know it.
You're a cop, aren't you?
What I am is your father. Right up until last night, we've been able to trust each other. What's happened?
This how you interrogate criminals?
Robin, look at me. When you set your jaw like that, I know exactly what you're doing. You're shutting everything out, me included. Robin, look at me. Look at me! Sweetheart. What on earth are you doing down there? And who are you trying to protect by running, you or me?
What do you want me to do, cop a plea?
Robin, we are going to talk about this, aren't we? I don't want to play these games. Okay, we'll talk when you're ready. Till then, you're grounded.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me. Stanley, what do you got?
Some guy named Bernard Spakenkill beat him up. You like the name, huh? Took his money. What else is new?
What did he get?
$2,000 cash, a couple of doodads from the shop. I tell you, Wes, these people are crazy.
How come you know the name?
Well, it's the fourth time he's hit this guy. He even knows where he lives. Can you imagine? The guy still won't go to court. I mean, this could go on forever.
Did you hear what I said?
What?
Cost of doing business, he says. Why do they call us? Will you tell me that? Why did they even bother?
What's his name?
Shosan.
Korean, huh?
What's the difference?
Stanley, they're not all alike. Mr. Chosant. Excuse me, Mr. Chosant, I'm Detective Kennedy. We both know this is going to keep happening unless you do something about it.
No, testify, please.
I'm not going to fool you. It won't be easy. You're going to have to pick him out of a lineup and then again in court.
No, can do. No can leave business.
He could kill you the next time, Mr. Chosant. Have you thought about that? How about your family? Who will take care of him then? You're not alone, Mr. Chosan. That's what I'm trying to impress on you. We can work on this together. Mr. Chosan, my name's on the front of the card. Call me. I'm Detective Kennedy.
All right. You got a look at him?
I don't remember.
You don't remember? Was he tall? Was he short? What? You don't remember?
Oh, thanks, Shirley.
Oh, will you tell Gomez? No, forget it. I'll do it myself. Okay, Well, your stereo was stolen. What else?
TV. My purse, my credit cards, my cash.
How much cash?
I don't know. I really don't remember.
You don't remember? Okay. Look, I don't know what we can do here. I really don't know.
Can I have some coffee?
Yeah, I suppose. Hold on.
Just black, please.
Miss? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you.
Hold on. You know, if you probe a little deeper, I think you just might find you got a rape victim there.
Oh, yeah. Did you catch your attitude?
That's what I'm talking about. A kid's traumatized. All you have to do is look at her to see it.
Well, hold on a second. Hot shot. What I got here is a class 3 case, all right? It's nothing. She's giving me zip.
I just think you got a rape victim. Put your sergeant's exam away for a while and just talk to her some more.
Hold on a second. Leave my sergeant's exam out of this, all right? It's none of your damn business. Now, this lady is not volunteering anything. What would you have me do, Mr. Kennedy? Take her in the back room and beat it out of her?
You know better than that.
Hey, you trying to kill us? That's all cholesterol.
You found me out. Now what'll I do?
Listen, did I ask you about dumping my braces?
Yes.
Guess it means nothing's changed. You think I could use your barbells and stuff?
Sure, if you're serious.
Well, look at me, Pop. No one in my class is looking for a guy with... I mean, look at me. And here I am trying to start a chess club. Some turn-on, huh?
Don't give me that.
Robin, breakfast.
Just a minute.
7 o'clock in the morning, and she's on the phone. Kevin, listen, I've been going over your report cards for the last 2 years.
Does that mean I'm in trouble?
Well, there's a kind of a pattern, and it worries me. With male teachers, you get A's and B's. All your bad grades come from female teachers. Now, what is that? You having some kind of problem with women?
Am I having problems with women? That's what I've been trying to tell you.
So is the problem with women teachers or just women in general?
Well, in general, they think of me as a nerd. Can't say as I blame them. I don't listen to their same music. I can't dance to their music. I don't dress the way they like it. I gotta change my image, Pop.
See her for 5 minutes and you ask her out. You know she's my best friend. My God, what do you do asking everyone who comes near you?
What's that all about?
You know, Mary.
Don't give me that. You don't care about me at all.
There's no Mary she's talking to.
Okay, then it wasn't love. It was infatuation, exactly.
Love?
Oh, but it's not with Mary.
I thought you had feelings about me, too, but you don't. Mary, come on, on, don't say that. Don't lie.
Pop, don't get in on this.
Well, maybe you should. Good, do it!
So, like I was telling you, I asked this one girl out.
You what?
What I did, didn't ask her. She liked to go to the flicks with me sometimes. And
just a minute.
What I'm trying to tell you is
why didn't you tell
girl.
Me this was going on?
Her name is Audrey.
You've got a boyfriend now?
Does it sound like it?
Why do I have to find out like this?
I can't do anything right, can I?
What I meant was you shouldn't hide things from me.
You never tell me about your work.
Some of it's pretty brutal.
Stop protecting me, will you?
Robin, what's happened to us? All of a sudden, I'm living with a hostile stranger.
If you're worried, forget it. I can take care of myself.
Yeah, I know. When I was a teenager, I thought I was bulletproof, too. Believe me, it's an illusion.
So you're gonna tell me about boys now? They're all after one thing, and it's not love, right? Don't worry about it. They're not getting near me. No way, no chance.
What's all this about Mary now?
Oh, he tells me he loves me and cares for me.
Who?
His name's Gary. Dirtbag. The next day, you know, he asks out my best friend. I really care for you, he says. I really love you. What's that?
It goes that way sometimes, sweetheart. I'm sorry, but it does.
Don't be. Don't worry about me. I don't ever want to fall in love. I am never getting married. It's all a hassle.
Where'd you get that? You think my marriage was a hassle?
Look how it turned out.
Robin, it was a good marriage.
My mother is dead. What is so good about that? Just leave me alone. I'll be all right because I am never getting married. Because then I'll never be dead.
Told you not to get in on it.
All you have to do, Mr. Chosen, is point him out. Take your time, and don't be frightened.
Kennedy, gotta see you for a minute. Stanley, take over, would you?
I'll be right back. What's up?
Well, for instance, that Oriental there, that is Stanley's case, but you moved right in on it, didn't you?
Sure, I moved in on it. Now that suspect's off the street. I got him off the street. Me, not Stanley. Stanley spends half his time hiding out in the field.
But what about Arnold?
Oh, come on, he knew it was more than simple robbery.
So did you get anywhere with her?
Ed. I still think it was rape. And I think what we got here is a bunch of old guys trying to hide out until they retire and a bunch of hotshot young kids looking for a quiet place to study. It's like a museum.
Wes, the city has invested a great deal of time and taxpayers' dollars training you as a SWAT team officer. Now, how do you think they feel upstairs, A man with your police skills operating at half his potential?
Hey, you know why I quit the SWAT team, Ed? Now, come on. And what do you mean, half potential? I'm clearing 24% of my cases. Arnold's 12, Stanley's 9.
Well, what he gets it down to, Wes, is that you're making the rest of the guys look bad.
Really? Well, then light a fire under them. Don't ask me to back off.
Nobody is asking you to back off. I'm telling you, we got a problem here. Maybe you ought to think seriously about getting off this shift.
Ed, you know I can't do that.
I know you won't do that.
All right, won't. Any other shift, my kids come home to an empty house, I won't have it, and you know it.
Well, let me tell you what I won't have. I won't have this problem anymore.
I don't believe you said that.
Believe it.
Well, Kennedy, somebody's asking for you.
How come you're pushing all the time?
Arno, I didn't ask for this. She came to me.
You? Why you?
All I know is the guy came back. She wasn't there, but he came back. He tacked a rose to a door and a note. He thinks he's in love.
Who are you talking about? My robbery suspect?
Yeah, remember I said you should probe a little further? The first time, the guy was there for 5 hours.
What?
Yeah, we got 5 counts of rape, 5286 and 3288. Read it yourself. Ain't love grand, eh? Well, don't spend all day reading it.
You want an apology?
No, Arno. I want the suspect. You know, if we cooperate a little on this, we just might nail the guy.
Don't talk to me about cooperation. All right, I don't think you even know the meaning of the word.
How's it going?
I don't know. I can't get it right.
You remember Detective Arnold?
Hello?
He left a note. He said he wants another date.
Well, let's hope he shows up. We'll be right there waiting for him.
You ever been to the Cipher Club?
Yeah, sure, a couple times.
Wait a minute. How's this?
Okay, let's see him.
Okay, Miss Comer. Thanks. I know this hasn't been easy for you.
Look, how about a cup of coffee? Okay?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks, Dick. Stanley! Stanley! Tell me who it is, Stanley.
The Cipher Club. The 187 suspect.
Right. Along with murder, you can add rape and all the rest. Now, all you have to do is find the guy. Somebody's got to keep trying, Pappy.
Come on, let's go, kids. Come on.
School's going down. I'm trying to transport the suspect.
Kevin, will you cut it out? Come on, Robin. Move it, will you? I want to get to bed now.
Dad, you're being overprotective.
Last month, a 12-year-old girl was taken down that 6 blocks from here.
Dad, the sun is out. That was at night.
I'm compulsive. Love has nothing to do with it.
I know.
Hey, Mary doesn't walk to school on her own now, does she?
She doesn't go to school at all.
What?
She dropped out.
Mary?
She dropped out of everything. I mean, she just split and hit the streets.
When?
I don't know, 6 weeks, maybe?
Mary's on the street?
Just let it alone, okay?
Oh, she can't handle that.
No, you'd be surprised.
What's that supposed to mean? Robin, why didn't you tell me this?
Why, so you could track her down?
Just a minute here.
You'd never recognize her anyway.
My father, the fanatic.
Watch it.
Rad, Dad. So rad, it drives you mad. Sorry.
What are you talking about?
You are so... I can't breathe around you.
You feel this way, too?
Well, you could lighten up a little bit. You tried too hard.
Beat's not trying at all. Believe me, I've seen what happens when it goes that way. Now, come on, in the car.
You know, sometimes I just hate you.
Watch where you're going, okay? Hey, excuse me, hey.
Don't wanna be, no matter. The blood of friends go out of me. And thus the call is misdirected.
About that murder, right?
Yeah, why, you know something?
Unreal. You mean that dude's still dead?
Music without a vision, and then they try to call it off. Here they constantly do cause a shock.
I didn't do it.
Now, by that, you can't do anything. Now, get lost, okay? Beat it! Excuse me. Excuse me, yo, bartender.
Hey, I'm Finnish. The Kennedy.
Hi, Danny. I thought you had enough of this place.
Yeah. Hey, look, I've been asking around and nobody knows nothing.
I appreciate that, Danny.
Yeah. Hey, he was a friend of mine, you know.
Yeah, I know. You got one of these?
No.
Okay, why don't you take it? I got more down the car, right?
All right.
Okay,
thanks.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah, thanks.
My number's on the back.
Another generation, another forward state of mind. It's somewhere deep within our consciousness. Is this a new
somewhere deep.
It's me! Mary!
Mary!
So his name's Gary, and he's supposed to be in love with Robin?
Gary is in love with himself. He's been doing all these numbers on her, though. Ego numbers. It's really got her crazy. I thought you knew about all that.
Not until the other night.
Anyway, it's 2 a.m., and there's Robin down at the Cypher Club looking for him. I'm all, don't be uncool. He don't hang out here. And she's all, he would, too. He digs you. I'm all, fat chance.
That's all she was doing down there, looking for Gary?
Friends of yours?
A couple of guys I work with.
Yeah, they look like cops.
You don't, though. That's a compliment.
Thanks.
Anyway, about Robin, she's just all mixed up. I don't know, like when her mother died, that was it. I don't understand her now. Nobody does anymore. And she goes, just relax. Everything's cool. But you know she's all broke up inside. Now, listen, Robin's 15 having a bad time. Life's tough, but it ain't gonna kill her. She's gonna survive. She's gonna be 16, then she's gonna be 17. You'll see.
How about you?
Life's tough, then you die, right? Big deal. Don't worry, I'll make it.
Look, I gotta hit the street. Kevin was right about you. You're a real tiger.
Thanks. It's your fault. Your fault.
All units in the area of 1627 Violet Street, shots fired. 2 out of 16
had a problem. I just want to make sure everything's okay with you and your family, so you guys don't walk around seeing what's happening. Okay, what I mean? Okay, you just be careful. You're running a rock house over here, pal. How's it, brother?
Louie, what's up?
The neighbors heard this shouting going on, and some ding-dong decided to empty a piece.
Anyone hit?
That doesn't look that way. Bullet holes all over the place, though. Count six so far.
Teenagers running a rock house?
Yeah, just when you thought you heard everything, right?
How old?
When we ran down to grand old age of 11, the other one looked to be about, maybe 16.
Actually running the rock house?
That's the way I make it. Of course, he says he was just hanging around.
What's the kid's name?
Got no ID. He calls himself Ricky, though.
Tender age of 11,
huh? Whoa, wait a minute. Tender. Brother, let me share something with you, okay? A little comma ina ingenuity. When the doctor slapped this kid, the kid slapped him right back, and I mean hard. And I'm glad you rolled on this one, Kennedy, because now you're stuck with him, and me, I get to go home. That's why you make the big bucks, right, bro? Mahalo nui loa, and aloha.
Ricky? So who did the shooting?
How would I know? I was just hanging out.
It's funny how we keep bumping into each other, isn't it? Your parents know where you are?
I forgot to ask.
Where do you live?
Forgot that one, too.
That's good. Getting along swell, aren't we? Where's your father?
Mom's still working on that.
Okay, where's your mother?
Depends. She kind of sleeps around.
You always this cooperative?
Only when I feel like it.
You're going down to the hall, Ricky.
All right. Get to sleep in a bed for a change.
Marjoilta maistuu, näkit et sä teille aurinkoon.
paistuu.
Uusi aurinkoinen. Pienikiteinen sokeri. Suojaa pakasten marjat. Sopii kakkuihin.
Näin kesän talteen saat säilöön. Sen tekee aurinkoinen.
Poveria paketissa Sanio täys hifi, kaukosäädin, CD-soitin 3990.
Voiko hyvä olla halpaa?
Kyllä, Sanio on.
MTVn kuuma kesä palauttaa yhtiön 30-vuotisjuhlavuoden kunniaksi kuvaruutuun katkelmia MTVn suosikkiohjelmista. 5 viikon aikana esitämme näihin ohjelmiin liittyviä kysymyksiä ja jokaisen viikon päätteeksi arvomme 30 palkintoa. Canon Top Shot-kamera, JVC-radionauhuri, Philips-jäätelökone, Tunturi-kuntopyörä, 6 MTVn Toivotaan levykokoelmaa sekä 10 kappaletta VR:n juhlavuoden rengaslippuja kahdelle hengelle ja 10 kappaletta matkahuollon bussilomalippuja samoin kahdelle hengelle. Viikkopalkintoja siis yhteensä 150. Kuuman kesän päätteeksi arvomme vielä kaikkien vastanneiden kesken Mitsubishi Colt EXE henkilöauton. Todella kuumaa kesää vietetään MTV:ssä. Tule mukaan!
You recognize me?
Tämä kunnon kansalainen teki pahan virheen. Lähti sokkotreffeille. Näet konnan koukkuulija Bruce Willis ja Kim Basinger villissä komediassa. Sokkotreffi.
Tällä viikolla T-kauppa ja Kympin kokki suosittelevat grillivartaita, salaattia ja muurinpohjalettuja. Hae kesän parhaat antimet T-kaupasta.
Sit here, Ricky. And stay put. Excuse me. I'm Ricky Priester's mother, the 11-year-old. I understand you're the arresting officer.
Yes, I am. What can I do for you?
I was wondering if you could tell me what happened.
Well, Mrs. Priester, you've been letting that kid of yours hang out all over town, usually late at night, and now he's gotten himself involved in a shooting.
Are you saying that's my fault?
According to your son, you don't have a regular job. You leave him alone for days at a time with nothing to eat in the house, and when you do come home, you either lock him in his room or kick him out. Now, is that accurate?
Mr. Kennedy, my son has been diagnosed as a borderline personality. He's almost sociopathic. He's also a compulsive liar, not particularly easy to deal with. Now, I suppose that might shock you coming from his own mother, but it's the truth, and I've stopped pretending that it isn't. That does not mean I don't care about him.
Let me ask you something, Mrs. Priester. Where were you at 3 a.m. when your son was involved in that shooting?
I work nights. All night for the last 6 years. I sleep while he's in school. At least that was the original idea. The problem is no one can keep him in school. No one can control him at all, for that matter. You're probably wondering if I beat him. Well, I don't. I never have. I don't believe in that sort of thing.
Have you sought help? Professional help?
Everything I can think of. Psychiatrists, that's plural. Psychologists. Churches, clinics, counseling. Nothing works. Absolutely nothing. I suppose. I suppose that somewhere down the line I must have done something wrong. Something awfully wrong. And I had to, didn't I? Kids don't turn into monsters by themselves, do they? Does a 6-year-old kid decide he's going to become a criminal? You know, a lot of people have told me to give up on him. Including 2 psychiatrists. But I won't. Besides, it's just the 2 of us. I'm all he's got. And he's all I've got. Anyway, I just won't quit. So if you have any more opinions about me, I would appreciate it if you kept him to yourself and tell me what happened with my son.
How's it going, sport?
See, I got this master plan. I gotta be less of a braid at first. Then, no glasses, no braces, all these rippling muscles. All right, somewhat rippling muscles. Anyway, this new me, okay? It's gotta attract some girl's eye, right? Maybe not this year, maybe next. Anyway, however long it takes, I'm gonna hang in there. There's gotta be some girl out there for me, right? You agree?
Will you stop that?
I've gotta change my image, Pop.
Just stop that for a minute. Come over here.
Kevin, you're beautiful.
Guess it means the braces stay.
Let me ask you something. Do you like yourself? Are you a nice guy? Because that's what counts. Can you live with yourself?
I sort of have to, don't I?
What I mean is, can you accept yourself, braces and all?
Audrey will never go for that.
Audrey? Who's Audrey?
No one. Just some little wimp in my homeroom. Actually, she's an unattainable love goddess, and she doesn't even know I'm alive. I question it myself sometimes.
That's exactly what I'm talking about, Kevin. Until you can accept yourself, zits and all, how do you expect anyone else to? You make those braces and glasses the most important thing about you.
I do? You mean I'm broadcasting something and I don't even know it?
You almost flaunt it.
Really?
The braces, the glasses, they aren't you, are they? They have nothing to do with your human worth, and that's all that counts, who you are.
Not at my age, Pop. Everyone's hung up on looks.
Well, you just said it yourself. There are a million girls out there, and one of them's got to be right for you. The image you got to change is right in there. Give it a try, will you? What do you got to lose?
Only that which is dearer than life itself.
One down already, one of us.
Mrs. Swan's going up?
We're on the way. Hey, what are you doing here? Dicks don't roll on these
cars. Run down the suspects for me, will you?
Two male cocks, medium everything.
The radio said three. What about the third?
Yeah, kind of Chicano, maybe.
Did you see him?
Yeah, sure.
You see him personally?
Sure, it was my description on the car. What's that?
Is that him?
I don't know. Could be.
Is that him?
It could be. I don't know. Maybe.
Hey, Kennedy?
Hey, Kennedy, where are you going?
Hey, that's a kill zone, man!
Inside! Inside!
Ah! Don't shoot, man! Don't shoot! Stop it! Stop it now!
That big entrance you made out there, you got one of your long words to describe it?
Yeah! Stupid, maybe. How's that?
No! No!
No, that's not long enough. What about kamikaze? You could be dead right now.
I know that. Hell, you ought to be dead! Oh, your kids would have loved that, wouldn't they? And it wasn't even the right guy.
Ed, I lost it. I don't know. I heard that suspect's description, and a fuse blew somewhere, I guess.
So you make this fanatic's entrance, and it's the wrong suspect!
Everything fit, Ed. Come on!
Do you honestly believe he'd come back to the city after what he did? Among other things, smoking two cops! And a cop's wife! Your wife! He is long gone. Wes, what's the matter with you?
I know what I did was inexcusable.
Oh, we are humble now. Isn't that refreshing?
You'll notice I'm being calm. The reason being, we finally got you by the stacking swivel. What I have here is a 181 personnel complaint filed by the field commander for improper tactics. Get ready for internal affairs. Your kids are gonna love that because they're gonna question him. And of course, we all know it's gonna come back sustained.
I lost my head, Ed. I'm sorry.
Needless to say, we all been expecting it. Okay, in the meantime, I want you out of here. I don't want to see your face again for at least a week.
Hey, Ed, come on! Give me a break!
Hey!
You got vacation time? Use it. Go somewhere. Diffuse yourself. In other words, Kennedy, get the hell out of here. Get out of my hair.
TV news says you're a hero.
It wasn't like that at all.
Just telling you what they said.
You could have been killed, Dad.
That's right. It's an awful damn fool thing to do.
Not a kind of mom, wasn't it?
Now, look, it's late. It's a school night. Why don't you two get back to bed?
This is a bad time to ask about my braces.
Kevin.
When's it my turn? There's always time for everyone else, but it's never my turn.
I'm still upset with you for busting in there like that.
I'm glad to hear it. It's been a long time since you said you love me.
Not more bad news, I hope.
Only for me. I'm not too proud of the way I treated you the other night. I want you to know that I'm sorry.
Does this mean I have to change my mind about cops?
What's wrong with cops?
Well, maybe I've just seen too many of them. Mainly, I object to their attitude. I'm Ricky's mother, and therefore categorically the bad guy.
Necessarily. What about your husband?
Yes, what about my husband? Last I heard, he was up in Canada somewhere. He never could deal with Ricky too well. I plan to divorce him as soon as I can afford it. Listen, I'm supposed to be working here. Can I get you something?
Don't talk much like a waitress.
Well, maybe that's because I have a degree in English lit.
Educated women, my weakness.
Hey.
Hi.
How about a cup of coffee?
I think I can handle that.
Hey, you don't understand. It was an invitation.
So, you always conduct your business this way?
Hey, I'm supposed to be the detective.
So you are trying to change my mind about cops.
Uh-huh. How am I doing?
Well,
you're good. I love this place in the morning. You ever been here?
No, this is the first time.
It's fabulous. Just starts to get alive
this
right about
beautiful.
Now. Yeah, it's just amazing.
What is it?
Go to the phone. Tell them where I am, that I'm requesting backup, and that I got a 187 suspect under surveillance.
187?
187. Don't worry, it's just routine. Excuse me? Excuse me? Excuse me, can I just talk to you for a second? Hey, wait! Out of the way! Out of the way! Everybody down! I'm a police officer!
How you defuse?
Ed, it was that 187 suspect. I am a police officer, you know.
Yeah, I guess.
Ed, I want to go back to work.
I don't suppose you learned anything from all this.
I'm trying my best not to.
Hey, you! Stop! Hey, man, which way are you going, huh?
I'm after the suspect.
So am I.
Who are you?
Kennedy, who are you?
Ed Van Duser.
Holy cow, it's Godzilla.
Tomorrow night. Museums are nice, but nothing moves.
It's supposed to be fun, I know.
It's supposed to be romantic.
Well, it is until you consider that I'm ticklish when you kiss me. There,
yeah,
you
I know.
It.
Yeah, I know you know it.
Ask for a buster. I love you, Wes.
I love you too, sir.
What are you telling us? We're just like this Ricky?
Hey, come on. I'm not comparing you to him. I just said the situations are similar. Kathy's a single parent. She works nights for the same reason I do.
Oh, so it's Kathy now. Whatever happened to Mrs. Priester?
Okay, Mrs. Priester.
Why? Who got shot?
No one got shot, Robin.
Well, then it's not the same thing at all. No one got shot in the street. No one left the house and never came back.
Two of you better begin to understand it was your mother's choice to go down there. I told her 100 times never to go near a police operation.
It was on TV. I mean, she was exercising and they had this bulletin.
I know that.
She saw the policeman like dead in the street. She thought it was you. That is what happened. That is what made her do it.
But she knew better, Robin. That's the whole point. She knew better and she went down there anyway. It was stupid.
Don't say that.
It was her decision, Robin. Bright, stupid, whatever. It was her decision and it got her killed.
I don't want to hear this.
Well, I'm through taking the hate for this.
And he stayed right on the force.
Of course.
Why?
Because that's who I am.
Then maybe I don't like who you are anymore.
Let me explain something to the two of you. Kevin? I could sell storm windows or aluminum siding or something like that, but it won't pull any murderers off the street or haul any rapists out of dark alleys. Damn it, what I do is important. There are people out there dying, and the thing we're short on is guys trying to stop all this carnage. I am one of those guys, understand? That's who I am. It's not just something I do for a living. It's who I am.
Do you have to bring it home to us?
I never do that.
Oh, yes, you do. When you get home, you are still enforcing the law.
Why? Because I hold you responsible for your actions? You're darn right I do. Like it or not, you're going to grow up knowing there are standards in this world. There are rules. And you better learn to live with them or you're not worth anything to anybody, including yourselves.
What do you want from us anyway? We're only kids.
He wants us to be fascists like him.
Let me tell you something about your fascist father. Picture how it happened. I don't know why I'm obsessed with that, but I am. As if there's some kind of solution out there. Maybe I can find it and bring her back. I don't know. It makes no sense. I just can't let it go. Never really thought about that, have you? What I'm going through. I think about it. I think about her every single day. At least every hour of the day, maybe more. I lost my wife out there. I love her. My best friend. Best friend I'll ever have. And it still hurts. And you know something? You never once asked me about it, neither of you. And that makes it hurt even more. How's the victim?
Well, the brother's got 3 holes in him. These guys said they saw a kid do it.
You people witnessed the crime?
Yes, sir, we did.
I saw all of you?
Yeah.
You say a kid did this.
That's right. There's this kid, this little kid. He turned around and he got this big gun in his hand. That's when all the shooting started. And the other boy, he go down, and the kid with the gun, he cut out down that way.
You got the piece, Kennedy. It's a .22 Browning handgun.
Hey, that's the kid right there. They got him.
You people certain that's him?
Yeah, that's him. Oh, yeah.
DHD. Well, Ricky, you really did it this time, huh?
So what? Little kids don't go to jail.
Don't they?
I can't explain it. 16-year-old lying bleeding in the street because of him, and I still love him. It's insane.
No, it's not.
How in the name of God does this happen? How does life get this way?
There's another thing, Kathy.
What? The world is coming to an end.
I'm going to have to testify against Ricky. We're going to be sitting there in court looking right at each other, and I'm going to have to tell the truth. Of course, it may not come to that. There's always plea bargaining. He may get home before we do.
I don't want him home. I know that's an awful thing to say. But I'm tired of all of this. I'm tired of the worry and the battle and the strangers knocking at my door. I'm even tired of loving him. Oh, God. What kind of a mother am I?
Yeah.
I just cannot stop hoping that someday he'll come around. Maybe it's unrealistic. Maybe it's futile. But I can't stop hoping.
Still in bed. Hey, come on. Move it, Ace. It was your idea to stay out late. Let's go, Kevin. Come on. Let's go get up. Come on, Kevin, let's go. Gotta get up now.
All right, all right.
Hey, you're really knocked out.
Yeah, kinda.
No, not kinda. You're really knocked out. Was it worth it?
It was better than that.
What was?
Yeah, well, did it last night.
Did what?
I did it last night. Well, you know.
You mean...
Right.
Did you use something?
Oh, come on, Pop. That's uncool.
Haven't I talked to you about disease? Lord, when I think of what's going around these days.
Okay, I used something.
What about the girl? Think about her. You don't want to take a chance, hurt her, and get her pregnant, do you?
She used something, too, I think.
Audrey?
Well, yeah.
So how was it?
See, I don't know. I mean, I've got nothing to compare it to. Never seen it done before.
I'm glad to hear it. You are a little young.
Not really. Not these days, Dad.
Kevin, this isn't something you do just because everyone else is doing it.
I know.
You care about her, don't you? You have a relationship, right?
Well, yeah. No, yeah, well, I don't know. I mean, it's not that, Dad. It's just that I have all these new feelings. Things I've never felt before, and it gets kind of mixed up.
Well, I warned you about that. I mean, it does change things.
But, I mean, the whole while, I mean, I couldn't stop thinking this is a really weird thing for two people to be doing. I couldn't get over that.
It does have its ridiculous aspects.
I want to do it again, though.
15, huh? Times change.
Yeah, you beat me by 6 years.
You waited till you were 21?
Yeah, what a night that was.
Oh, you remember that far back?
Hey, knock it off.
So tell me about it.
Well, number one, I was scared to death.
Me too.
Crazy things went through my mind. I'm thinking, good Lord, here's this girl here, this person, and she's offering herself to me, which is pretty awesome. Right then, I wanted to run right out of the room.
God, that's it exactly. Just exactly the way it was with me. So, come on, tell me about it. How'd it go? How'd it come out?
Well, I decided that I'd like to try it again, too.
God, that's it exactly. I don't believe it. I'm human after all.
See you at breakfast. Right there, you wimp.
Matthews!
I'm sorry I missed you the other night.
Oh, yeah? Sorry I missed you.
Look, nobody's perfect. You're not only a lousy shot, you're a lousy human being.
Oh, you're busted!
Yours?
Oh, yeah.
You got my suspect, my rapist killer suspect.
Well, somebody's got to do things right around here. Isn't that what you're always saying, Kevin?
That's what I'm always saying.
Fifth and Main, you know the taco stand? He was code 7. And the fool came in and sat down right next to him.
Ow! Calm down, will you, Stanley? Look, what happened is this, all right? The guy sits down. I put the arm on him. He gets a little upset, which is only natural. We duke it out a bit. The rest is history.
You took him down alone, eh?
That's right. Doesn't that burn your tail?
Look, Arno, I had my chance and I blew it. You got him off the street. And that's what counts.
Oh, wait. Hold on a second. Be honest with me now. You trying to tell me this did not tear you up?
Arno, remember when I was telling you about the two of us cooperating? This is what I meant. I identify the suspect, you bust him. Feels kind of good, doesn't it? Congratulations.
How do you figure that?
Look, I'll make the dinner. All I'm asking is you pick up a little bit for me. No big deal.
My father is dating.
It's been a year and a half almost. Life goes on, you know.
I gotta get ready for dating. I mean, people sleeping over and all like that. I can't handle it.
I knew it. I mean, I just knew it the minute this Kathy stuff started. I just knew it.
I think I'll go hang myself.
Women.
You look lovely tonight.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry. There's been a hitch about dinner. I haven't made it yet. But don't worry. I'm a whiz in the kitchen. It'll be ready before you know it. Something wrong?
I can't do it.
Can't do what?
This. Dinner.
Pretty sure about that, huh?
Yes.
Does it have anything to do with my being a cop, or is it more personal?
What I can't get around is that you're going to get up on that stand and take my son away. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Will you kiss me? Mm-hmm. Honest, you do. At first I thought it was infatuation, but ooh, it's lasted so long. Now I find myself wanting to marry you and take you home. I know, I know, I know you send me. I know you send me.
Come in.
Sometimes it's hard to sort out the good news from the bad. You ever notice that? You know that old routine? That's good news. No, that's bad. Yes, that's bad news. No, that's good.
Dad, what are you talking about?
Kathy's not coming for dinner.
She's really not coming?
It's not the best thing that ever happened to me, but it's not the worst either. See what I mean? The really bad news is now I'm not very hungry, and there's that dinner out there. That was a beautiful thing you did for us. For me. So you see, it's really good news.
Ricky, I bet.
Yeah, you got it.
Oh, boy.
Robin, do you know how much I love you? Have any idea?
No.
Oh, yes, you do.
No, I don't. I know how it used to be.
Well, maybe we could get back there somehow. What do you think?
I don't know.
Do your old man a favor. Come over here, will you? Come on. Just come over here, will you? Give me a hug. Come on, it's not gonna hurt.
Family again? Don't answer that.
Dad, I love you.
Kylmää terästä näemme siis kesäkaudella joka torstai tähän samaan aikaan. Ja huomenna MTV esittää ohjelmaa taas molemmissa verkoissa. Ykkösverkossa on Enkeli maantiellä kello 19.30. Ja täällä kakkosverkossa tapaamme 10 uutisten aikaan. Niiden jälkeen kello 22.20 näemme juhlaohjelman James Bondin 25 vauhdin vuotta. Ohjelma esittelee James Bond maailmanmenestyselokuvat Sean Connerista Timothy